Okay, Tintinnabuli. What is it? It is a style, a form, a way to compose, a technique, whatever you want to call it, made, invented, discovered by this guy. Arvo Pärt, however you want to say it. He is an Estonian composer and has been doing it for a long time. First worked under the Soviet Union, then fled to Germany, some other countries, I just forgot, sorry, and back to Estonia after the fall of the wall. Anyway, this is a very good piece of footage. I would love to show you, but I think it will get put from YouTube. So here's the title, watch all parts, watch them 100 times like I did. It is just fascinating. I'll skip through a few things, like here. He's directing the orchestra and the conductor. Later on, you see him talk with the musician and everything. It's very interesting. Anyway, what is Tintinnabuli? Tintinnabuli means bell or clock, a church bell, that sort of thing. It is polyphonic music where one voice is written against the other. Let me give you a few examples. So, yeah, it's doing it. Before this, there was something very wrong with it. It was a very interesting tuning. Let's call that. Anyway, so Tintinnabuli. One voice. It's just free, just plays a scale, but the other only plays chords. And the way which tone goes with the other is the whole point of it. So, I will draw you. It will be a lot easier to see, in my opinion. So, we have our B minor scale. And how you would write notes against it is you take the B minor chord. So you have B, F sharp, and D. And then you look at the chord of the tone in the melody, it's a B. Which chord note is the closest one under it? Well, A is not a chord tone, G is not a chord tone, F sharp, so F sharp. And the same goes for the next one. What is the closest chord tone going down from A? It's not G, it's F. Same with G. Now we're with F sharp, so then we go down to D. E, D, D, B, C sharp, B, B, F sharp. And that's it, basically. It's very easy, very straightforward, and the results are pretty astounding for such a simple thing. I'll play it. Can freely transpose this, so instead of such close phosings, you can transpose it an octave. So, you see, it's it sounds very nice. You can also change the position of the chord, so now the chord notes are all under it. You can also choose the chord tone above it. So, what's the closest chord tone above B? It's D. Above A, it's B. Above G, it's B. Above F sharp, it's B. Above etc., etc., etc. Then you got something like this. You can also say, I don't want the first one, I want the second one above it or below it. Let's put below. So the first one is F, then the second one is D. Etc, etc, etc. D, blah, blah, blah. Bam. So it would sound something like this. And if you want to go crazy with it, you can do a sort of florid style where you interchange all these styles and ways so that you don't follow one particular. But it doesn't have to. You can do all the things in like this position or in the position above. It really doesn't matter. He described it as like the bond between heaven and earth. Like you have the free scale and then you have the heavenly tones that clash with the free but still draw it near something good. At least that's how he described it. Cool thing you can also do with this is like you can have a melody. Let me see something very simple. Let me see. I have to figure out something. So we take a very simple melody. Oh wait, no, I know a good melody. Some of you might know this melody. So according to the Tintinnabuli principles, we would harmonize this like this. Closest to D, we're in the scale of D minor. So the closest to D is A. Closest to F is D. Closest to D, blah, 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 blah. And you see how easy this is. You don't have to think about it at all. Because it's simple. And simple things are often very nice. So, like that. Or not, it doesn't have to be like that. Let's do it like this. It's okay, but I would like to show you something, a trick I use it oftentimes, because he also said sometimes the beauty in things is not showing where it comes from. Well, if you just take this, so we remove the original melody and now we only got the chord tones. And that already sounds pretty nice, I think. You see, you can make all kinds of cool variations on very complex melodies, very intricate. Like, you can have with all kinds of strange rhythms, and then you can just simplify it. Let's put it like this. Bump. I don't know if this sounds cool. Not really. But anyway, it's just for a demonstration purpose. So let's say we're in D B flat. B flat, B flat. So, like this, and then we just erase this, the original line. And then we do one more thing, we simplify. So, bam. We could even, nah, let's do it like this. So then we have, so out of nonsense we made something pretty beautiful. So that's it. And yeah, I think it's a very cool technique, especially for electronic music, because I don't know, it just lends itself to it. So like if you have very simple arpeggio, let's something very simple. Play it, please. Play. So very simple, let's make it more interesting. Oh wait, that's not a very good example. You know why? Because they're only chord tones. Okay, so let's unchord tone them. Okay. So they're now on chord tones, and let's add some chord tones. Okay, still sounds somewhat weird, but it's already a lot nicer than what it was. Now, let's get rid of the closed voicing, so the dissonances won't sound that harsh. Some strange things going on. Some strange clicking. Let's see if we can fix it. Like this, simplify. It's still very strange, but you get the point. This is not this is like educational purposes only, you know. Anyway, that was it about it. I hope you can learn something from it. Hope you can use it and abuse it, and yeah, make sure this this guy gets his respects, because he is cool. Okay, goodbye.